Continuous test of single phase induction motor. In this video, we will see how to do a continuity test on a single phase induction motor. For this test, we need a multimeter. To start with, make sure that you set it to the correct setting to measure resistance or continuity. We need to test the resistance between each post in the terminal box. We have numbered the posts 1 up to 6. We start by measuring the resistance between posts 1 and 2. We get an infinite reading indicating an infinite amount of resistance. In other words, no connection between post 1 and 2. Now we measure the resistance between post 1 and 3. Again, we get an infinite reading indicating no connection. We continue by testing between posts 1 and 4. Again, no connection between the posts. Next, we continue testing post 1 and 5, and this time we get a resistance reading. In this case, it is 5.6 ohms. This indicates that there is a continuity between post 1 and 5. We need to make a note of this reading on the diagram of the terminal box. We finish this round of testing by testing for continuity between post 1 and 6. We can see that there is no continuity. We start the next round between the terminals 2 and 3, and there is no continuity. And also there is no continuity between post 2 and 4, or between post 2 and 5. But there is continuity between post 2 and 6. We get a reading of 4 ohms. We add this result to our diagram, noting that the resistance reading is lower than the previous one. We begin the next round of testing, starting with post 3. We find that there is a continuity between post 3 and 4. We get a reading of 0.6 ohms. We mock this result on our diagram that there is no continuity between post 3 and 5, nor between 3 and 6. Looking back at our diagram, we can now identify a start winding, the run winding, and the centrifugal switch. The start winding made from the thinner wire gauge will always have the higher resistance. The centrifugal switch will always have the lower resistance close to zero, and the run winding will be the reading in between, but the reading must be closer in value to the start winding and the centrifugal switch. We can now feel the result of our continuity test on a motor test for everything is as expected it to be. So we can mark each test as passed or acceptable. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe.